Hey guys, how's it going? Well, I'm so excited because basically Microsoft have just literally released the update 2 so that we can all try their Flight Simulator 2020 in virtual reality. I'm going to show you how to do the patch install update, all of this kind of stuff, and give you my first impressions. Let's go. By the way, big welcome to VR Essentials. We talk about the practical uses of virtual reality and VR educational entertainment. If it's your first time here to the platform, very nice to meet you. And of course, a huge welcome back to all our regular subscribers. It's always awesome to have you with us. In the previous video, I showed you how to purchase the game from $1 only through the Xbox Game Pass and go through the entire installation process to update it. Of course, depending where you bought it from, there might be various different processes. If it's from Steam, I think you still have to download it via the Microsoft Store, but if not, generally speaking, the updates are automatic via Steam. If not, you have to go to the Microsoft Store, search for your game that you had purchased, and then click on the three little dots there, right click on it, and then see that it actually needs to be updated. For Xbox Game Pass users, if you purchased it for $1, then all you have to do is open your app, then go to My Collections, which is on the top left hand side, and then simply wait. You'll see there's going to be a little thing saying checking for update, and then once that's finished, you'll see that in fact you have to update it. So just click on update all if you only have that game in your library. Otherwise, just update the actual Flight Simulator 2020. Now, once you're done downloading the update from either the Xbox Pass or from your Steam VR or from your Microsoft Store, you actually have to launch the app. Now, what's going to happen is after you launch it, it's going to tell you that indeed there's an update that also has to be done there. Now, the file size is about 10 gigabytes and it can take about 15 to perhaps half an hour to download. So do be patient, maybe, you know, go and do some other things whilst, you know, it's auto updating. Also, what you can do is just read all the various different updates, because it's not only actually the VR mode that's been updated. They've actually increased and added some planes and fixed a whole bunch of different bugs. So it's always good to know, you know, what's actually new in the game. Now, once the installation has processed and the update is done, just click on next to go to the next screen. And then the game is simply going to load up to the main menu. Now, you notice in the menu at the bottom left-hand side, especially for those who actually have used this before and, you know, they didn't see this before, but of course, if it's your first time, you won't know the difference. But basically it says toggle in VR with the control and then tab button. So you have to both hit control and tab in order to go in VR. And there is another way to make some changes. So what you can do is go to options at the top, click on that, and then click on general on the next screen. And this will lead you inside to basically the graphic settings. And you can make some changes there as well as toggle in or out of VR. Now, make sure you are part of the notification squad by enabling the notification bell after you subscribe, so you don't miss the next video where I'll basically be taking you through all the various different graphic settings and sharing with you my best settings, which may actually be very helpful to you. Now, depending on the VR headset that you have, for us with the HP Reverb G2, we have to at this stage launch the mixed reality software. But I don't really think it matters whether it was launched before or it was launched after. I'll do some testing and post that to the channel as we go along. But once it's basically launched, then what you do is just hit the control plus tab button and everything inside will already be transformed into VR. Now, if you want to recenter the view, all you have to do is hit the space bar on your keyboard and it'll recenter everything automatically for you. Now, once you're in VR, in order to go through the various different screens, in order to go into some gameplay, you need to use your mouse. If you use your controllers, it's simply not gonna work, or it's not working with me at the very moment anyway. All right, well, here we are inside the cockpit and it feels really amazing. I mean, it's so different to be inside of VR instead of looking at it from my actual screen, which I've been doing for the last few days and waiting furiously for this patch to come so quickly. But here it is, and it's just amazing because I can literally lean out and look out the window, do some turns, and oh man, it just feels really incredible. Now, by the way, if you want to learn how to capture a video so you can share it with your friends and you can show the whole screen, or you can take screenshots and pictures and share those with other people, then go and check out another video which I uploaded, because I actually show you all the various step-by-step guide as to how to do that. Guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. I'm completely blown away. This is phenomenal. I really can't wait to upload more content. But until next time, take it easy and I'll see you in the next video.